exclusive forecast is provided by WLKY Weather. Whenever you need the forecast, just ask, what's Jay say?
Hi, everybody. I'm WLKY Chief Meteorologist Jay Cardosi. Some nice events going on around Kentuckiana as we move into the upcoming weekend. Riverfest continues in Madison along the riverfront Saturday and Sunday. Check it out. What a great event. We also have the Backyard Barbecue Blast going on Saturday. It's a cook-off contest. On one side, we have professionals. On the other side, amateurs. So we got music, food, races, and boat rides. A little bit farther off to the south in Shelbyville, we have the Battle of the Bluegrass Pulling Tractor Show. That's Saturday at 7 o'clock in the afternoon, in the evening. Again, a great event, so check that one out as well. Here's your forecast. For Friday, it looks great. Decreasing clouds, temperatures in the 80s. On Saturday, a slight chance for a shower, otherwise lots of dry time. And again, those temps in the mid to upper 80s.
Hey, Jay, tell us, what do you say?
Hey, Jay, what do we say?
We can count on you.
After two decades, we can say a lot about Jay Cardosi. We can say he has your most accurate forecast and is the Ohio Valley weather expert. But it's not about what we say. What matters is what's Jay say. What's Jay say about your weekend plans, your Little League game? His answer is still the one more people trust. Want to know the forecast? Just ask.
What's Jay say?
Hello, we're here in Madison, Indiana with Kurt Jacobs of the Madison Courier and Steve Thomas of Thomas Family Winery, but they've teamed up and they're doing some really cool things. And what is that, Steve?
Well, we started, when the Riverfest started, we started an amateur barbecue championship competition and big party called the Madison Courier Backyard Barbecue Blast. And we started that, and this is our 16th year.
Oh my goodness. Now, Kurt, I know the Madison Courier sponsors this. What is your involvement with that?
Well, I mean, our main involvement is cutting a check. You know, Steve really does all the work, and right. You know, sometimes we'll put our tent up down there and we'll come around. It's really just fun for us. So
right.
That's really it.
You just make that event possible.
Yeah, yeah.
That's really good, though. I mean, more people need to help out with different things.
They perform a bigger service than that. Among the things they do, in the paper, they pass out barbecue tips. They tell people what's happening, the right way to cook things. They'll publish winners' recipes
right. And
things. So there's a little more than they do.
There's a little more sweetener in the sauce.
That's exactly right.
But that's great. He needs to do that. He's good at that. Now, with the barbecue, you have the contest. How do you judge who wins and by how?
We don't strictly follow the Kansas City Barbecue Society rules. We use a lot of their rules, but we look at this more like a big family reunion. And you know, Uncle Jim and Uncle Frank decide to do the barbecuing for it, and we judge it accordingly. We put a lot more weight on texture and flavor than we do appearance. You don't have to carve the ham to look like a duck or anything.
Oh, no.
You just have to make it very good, make it wonderful, and make everybody smile.
And I think there's going to be a lot of them doing that this weekend, isn't there?
Yes, there will. About 60 of them.
60 vendors.
60 teams.
Oh my goodness. Now, Kurt, how long have you all been sponsoring this?
You know, we've been in it from the start. You
right.
know, I can't remember who called me up, and we thought it was a great idea from the start. And you know, I'll echo what Steve says. What the thing that's been fun about sponsoring this is, they have such a good time. So like a lot of times, I'll come down and do the awards with them, and on that Friday night. And you can tell everybody's had a great time, and if you go through when they're doing it, you know, there's a bunch of characters and they're having a good time, and we've had some former employees who who I think were involved, and they had a great time. So it's just been a positive experience for us the whole way.
Well, I know,
we've been in it from the start.
I know you all have a passion for it because you look forward to it, and you start talking about it way before the event happens. Mm-hmm. So that's really good. Now, Steve, is there anything that we need to tell people that are coming in from out of town? What is the something that they might need to know?
Well, if you come into town and you're not sure exactly what exactly you're going to find out on the east side of the barbecue is the amateur side of the competition. Uh-huh. Now they start at 6 a.m. and they start 6 a.m. on Friday, and they're rolling by the time you get there. On the west side are the pro teams, and they just are really getting cranked up, and they're really kind of getting in panic mode by Saturday morning. So this whole little part of the valley fills up the most incredible smells that you'll ever find.
Oh, goodness. I see Kirk smiling.
Yeah, you can smell it at our office, you know. Makes you want to come down.
Makes you want to leave the office for a while and go
sure
get something
does.
To eat.
Sure does.
Well, this is great. Now, if you come to this event, what do they need to do? Do they buy tickets? Do they come in and can they taste the food? How does that all work?
Well, you don't have to have a ticket to come see our event. And some teams that might give out a few samples, but really it's... they're kind of having fun, their families are there,
right.
And you know, that's what they're doing. To get into the event, you need a wristband. And that wristband you can buy all the way anywhere, you know, at some of the places and at the offices up until Thursday afternoon. Then starting on Friday, you have to buy it at the event.
At the event. So a lot of people are going to be buying it at the event, which will be at the gates where they can get in down on Vaughn Drive.
Yes.
So they can do that. But they can't taste the food? I mean, that's what I think.
Well, they can, but it's not an expected thing.
Right.
It's not required of the cookers to do it.
So they don't have to.
Yeah, they don't have to.
They're just competing.
But, you know, you can come down and meet them and say hi and just watch them. Just watching them, there's, like I said, there's some characters down there.
Yeah, and they really get into the cooking.
They do. They have a good time.
That's their passion, is making that food. So
they do, but still it's just a big backyard party for them. So.
And, you know, I don't know if Steve mentioned, I mean, we've had a lot of teams go on into the pro ranks, haven't we?
You know, we figure about one a year, maybe a little over one a year from our area and the people that come. You know, we get people
that's
from Michigan,
great.
Illinois, Ohio, Kentucky, you know, that come to our backyard barbecue blast. And you know, yes, we do graduate about a team a year. He's right.
That is awesome. That's really great. Now, is there anything else we need to make sure people know, Kirk?
Again, Steve would be the guy to tell you because, you know, he knows the ins and outs and, you know.
Well, it's just wonderful to come down and watch how everybody works. And then you have a lot more vendors where you do buy food in the event.
Oh,
you
yes.
know, I think up to 10 different ones, and I think 7 of them are barbecue vendors. And that's wonderful. Big selection of beers and wines and music. And everybody knows the big falderal, but, you know, you have 120 people. 120 barbecue teams in our 10 block area. And it's like nothing else in the state of Indiana. And that's why we're known, you know, soon to be known as truly the barbecue capital of Indiana because of it.
And great music, too.
Right.
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, that's just great. So, well, we need to make sure people know about it, make sure they make it down and get out. And
we're glad you're here.
Well, thank you. We're glad y'all took time today with us. So now, can you give everybody your website so they can check it out?
The MadisonRiverFest.com. www.MadisonRiverFest.com.
Okay.
And then you can also find things here.
At the Madison Courier.
Yeah, www.MadisonCourier.com. We'll have coverage of the event.
Right, yes. Yeah, they'll be there and they'll be bringing stuff. So you can read this in the paper, follow up and find out what's going on afterwards and who won and all that through the Madison Courier. So you all try to make it out. And as always, we thank you for watching. Hello, we are here with Brad Powell, who is really into tractor pulling, and this is really cool. These guys actually go on a circuit. Brad, how long have you been doing this?
You've been pulling about 15 years now.
Now, did you decide to do this, or did Dad drag you into it?
Dad bought me a tractor, a farm stock tractor, and we slowly started pulling to where we are now.
Oh my goodness. So
you actually can work on the tractors and you take care of them and yep. do it all. So that's the fun side of it, I think.
Sometimes.
Do you actually, you have a part doesn't fit right, it's not too much fun.
Yeah.
So do you actually pull them or do you have somebody that pulls them for you?
No, we pull them also.
You all do it yourselves?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's even better. So now with the circuits you all are on, how far does that circuit go? What is the basic range for it?
We run a lot of the Ohio Valley, Ohio, Kentucky, Tennessee. We'll go to West Virginia, Illinois, Michigan, and Wisconsin some also.
Oh, that's a pretty good trip,
mm-hmm.
especially on a weekend.
Yeah. That's a pretty good haul.
Yeah, you kind of shut down the business for the day and take off.
Yeah.
Well, if Dad's going with you, you don't have to get his permission.
There
he just goes too. That's pretty cool. Now, you actually are passing this down. You're not the only one that pulls tractors. Your dad and you do, but there's someone else that you've gotten involved in.
Yeah, my nephew Tyson. We got him a tractor this year, and he started coming with us, and he really enjoys it.
Oh my God! And how old is Tyson?
He's six.
He's 6 years old, and he's got his own tractor.
He does. He's in first grade at St. Matthew's Elementary School.
Oh my goodness! Now, who named his tractor?
He did.
And his tractor's name is what?
Big Willie.
Big Willie. I just think that's so cute. Y'all gotta see this tractor in a minute. So.
It was a Christmas present for Tyson, and
right.
He
really took to it.
He really did.
Oh, wow. Well, that's kind of neat, though. I mean, how many kids get to spend the weekend with their uncle and their dad and their grandfather? You know, that builds a big bond between
right.
you guys.
Yeah. And then when he grows up, maybe he can start pulling, too.
Well, he can pull the little tractor
yeah.
anyway.
Yeah.
So that's great. He can do it at all the local fairs.
Yep.
They always have those. So
mm-hmm.
that's kind of cool. Now, is there anything this weekend? There's a big event you all have going on. What do we need to tell everybody about that event?
Saturday night at 7 o'clock, we'll be at the Shelby County Fairgrounds in Shelbyville, Kentucky. There'll be six classes running, two-wheel drive trucks, diesel and alcohol tractors. It's $15 to get in, and the show starts at 7 o'clock.
Right. Well, we'll try to make sure. I'm going to try to be there. Your dad's giving me that scowl that I need to be there, so I'm going to have to try to make it out to this. Now, there's something unique about the tractors behind us. Two of them are alcohol tractors and two are diesel. Now, tell everybody what the difference is in those type of tractors.
Well, two of the tractors have been converted to run on alcohol, so they've got a different fuel system and a different ignition system than what a diesel factory tractor would have.
Right. In your opinion, which one pulls the best?
We like the alcohol, but a lot of people like the diesel.
Oh, well, I guess everybody has their favorites.
It's all in what you know, I guess.
Well, it's so nice of you to be here with us today, and I really appreciate this. I'm sure everybody out there is going to enjoy finding out what's going on with the diesel tractors and the alcohol tractors and the pulling circuit, so this
yep.
is great.
And if they have any other questions, they can go to bluegrasspulling.com, look us up on Facebook at the POW Pulling Team, or Battle of the Bluegrass Pulling Series.
Oh, that's great. Now, is there a phone number that they can contact people, or just go to those websites?
Just go to those websites, and they've got contacts. And,
okay.
Should have all the information on there.
Well, great. Well, thank you so much for being with us. And as for you all, as always, thank you for watching.